This tutorial is going to show you how to take a Photoshop file that we've split up from a graphic and animate it in After Effects. So we did this in the previous tutorial, but I'm going to grab that Photoshop file and pull it into my bin in After Effects. And you can see what it does is it gives me a few options here. You can do footage, you can do composition, or composition retain layer sizes. In this case, I'm going to retain the layer sizes and make them editable layer styles. When I click OK, you can see it does two things. It gives me a composition that's intro clear view, the same name as that file. And this, when I double click it, opens it up, and you can see very subtly here that one piece is my bar from that logo, and the other piece is something you can barely see. You might not be able to see it on YouTube, but it's you can see the edges of that black piece. And the reason why we can't see them is because there's no solid behind this to show us the black there. And then also gives it to us in layers. So it gives me each of those layers individually, which is very handy. So what I'm going to do is actually make a new composition, and I'm going to call this separated logo, so I know which one's which. And I'm going to leave it at a background color of black. And then what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to bring, that's in a random spot there, so I'm going to drag that out so it's not inside my layers piece here, though. And then I'm going to take my layers and put them into my comp, and you can see it gives them to me. It doesn't line them up. It doesn't keep them lined up like the composition would, but it does allow me to kind of see where they are and mess with them a little more, which is pretty useful. So, and of course, you can always just move these over. In this case, I'm just pressing the right arrow, but you could just change your x-axis or drag it around if you wanted to. And again, you can see that we can't really see the logo here. So I'm going to toss a solid behind this. And I don't have a white solid, so I'm going to make one. So I'm going to go to layer, new, solid. And I'm going to change my color to white. It was already on white, but I'm changing it to white and put it in. And you can see that it's on top, so it's actually obscuring all of that. So I'll just go down here into my timeline and then drag it down to the bottom. So you can see here, I've got one layer that is my little orange bar, one layer that is the copy from the logo, and then one layer that is the white solid. So what I need to do now is to animate these. And I'm not really going to worry too much about position here. If I wanted to move around, oh, that's the solid. If I wanted to move around the little orange layer, I could, you can just select it and drag it over. Just to give us a little more of an idea of where we want to end up being. But I really want to end up animating this. So the first thing I'm going to do is to make these 3D. And so I'm just going to click here and drag down, or I could click them individually. And all three need to be 3D. And then I'm going to add a light. So I go to layer, new, and light. And of course, you don't have to do this in this order, but it gives you some idea. So I can choose my type of light, which I usually use spot. You can choose the color of the light, which is really cool. And this is also animatable, as are all of these other issues, that your angle, how fuzzy the edges of the light will be, how intense the light will be, whether it casts shadows, etc. I'm going to click cast shadows, just so that it'll save me a little bit of time later on. So I'm going to click OK. And you can see that it basically gives me a light here. And if I didn't have these 3D, we wouldn't actually see the light effect at all. But because it's in three dimensions, you can. So I'm going to mess around with this a little bit, but I want to be able to get a little bit more of a feel for my light. So the first thing I'm going to do is go to Custom View 1, which is going to give it to me at an angle. And I can press the key C for camera, or I can just click up here on my camera icon. And then I can click and drag around to see where things are. So here I can see that my light is positioned in this way. There's the focal point here and right over here. And you can drag and move that around. And you can move it up on the y-axis, you can move it on the x-axis, or you can move it on the z-axis to go back and forth. So maybe I'll do z, and then I'll move it over a little bit on the x-axis. And you can see how when you roll over this, it actually gives you that little icon that says it's the x-axis, or the y-axis, or the z-axis. So you have a feel for things. So the next thing I want to do is actually mess with this a little bit in terms of casting shadows. So I'm going to move this up a little bit on my y-axis, and then I'm going to drag the focal point down a little bit. And the reason I want to do this is because, just like any other light, you want to be able to give some direction to the shadows. So I'm going to open up my material options to get a feel for this. So I want to open up my white solid and go to my material options and make sure that it accepts shadows, and it does, and it accepts lights, which it does, obviously. So that's good. And then I want to do the same for these two layers. So I'm going to go to layer one. I'll see material options. Okay, here it says cast shadows is off. So I want to make sure that this is on and accepts lights is on and all of that. So that's good. And I'm going to go to my second layer and do the same thing. So material options, cast shadows on. All right, then we should be good to go. So now what I want to do is just move these up a little bit. So I'm going to highlight them both and press P for position. And of course, you could open them up individually if you wanted to. And then we're going to move them on the Z axis, so move them closer to us. And so I can just drag to the left is going to move them closer to us. To the right is going to move them further away. You can notice when I drag closer to us how we actually get a shadow behind it from the light. And it works just like a real light would. This shadow is incredibly dark, so it's maybe not exactly what we're looking for. So if I go to active camera, you can see, wow, that's a really dark shadow that's just not going to work for me. So it could make some really cool effects, of course, but it's a little much. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my my light, and I'm going to change my light options, and I can change my shadow darkness. And I'm going to make this maybe 40%, somewhere around there to give me a better feel for it. But you can see how cool this ends up being almost immediately. And remember, all of this is transformable. So you can change, you can actually animate how dark the shadows are over time, and you can animate your color. So let's say if I wanted it to be at white to start with, but then I want to change it to, I don't know, a blue light 2 seconds in, I can do that really easily by just making it a blue light. And of course blue doesn't reflect red, so it actually kind of makes it look like a black light. So I would press spacebar to preview, and you can see that it actually animates that color change. And of course you can do the same thing with the angle of the piece. So let's say I want to remove that because I don't really want it to be blue. So, let's take it off, but let's animate instead our position and our feather or something, right? So, let's say right here we want to, change our position and our point of interest. So let's animate both of those. And let's say we want to move it around a little. So I'll go back to custom view one so we can see. So let's say at this point, I want it to be, well, that can be at an angle, but let's not do it at an angle. Let's just move it up and to the right. You have to be very careful about moving this centerpiece because it starts to kind of throw everything out of whack a little bit. But let's say that's where I want it to be. And let's move it a little bit closer so it's a little brighter. Oh, that should be okay. I can always change my intensity if I want to. And then let's move a few seconds in, maybe 4 seconds in. And I'll do the same thing. So I'm going to move it around a little bit. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. I'm going to move it on my x-axis over. And I'm going to move it down on my y-axis. And I want to move the point of interest up this time. So let's leave that pretty much in the same spot. But let's keep moving this over a little bit. So notice this is only going to be one animation because I'm staying in the same spot. And of course, I could just move the point of interest. I mean, I could move it down here if I wanted to animate all of that together. And what this is going to do is it's actually going to change the shadow, of course. So when I move to the beginning here and I go to my active camera, so what I'm actually going to end up seeing, let's deselect so you don't see the little lines there and preview it by pressing spacebar. You can actually see that what we're getting is a really subtle and really beautiful movement. Now, you could just do this as one composition, right? So the logo is all one piece. The reason why I don't do that is because I'd like to be able to move these things individually. So, so let's say I want to have these pieces animate in a little bit. And so let's move down my light a couple of seconds. And so here, if I press U to see my keyframes, you can see the keyframes are in the same spot. So I just moved it over and then expanded it out. But let's say I want these to animate in at this point. So let's say right here, for this piece. So let's have the line come in first, let's say. Or let's have the copy come in first. So let's open up opacity. And at this point, we want it to be at 0%. And then, oops. And then well, just a little bit in, we want it to be at 100%. So let's say by the time we get here, we want it to be 100%. Okay. And then let's say at the same time, we want this piece to come in right after that. So let's animate this at 0. And then let's go forward. So when the light starts to move, let's have this come out to 100%. And so what this is going to look like is one piece is going to move or going to fade in, then the other piece is going to fade in, then we're going to have the light start to shift. So one piece fades in, the other piece fades in, and then the light moves around. So it becomes a very cinematic little logo and very beautiful. And certainly in comparison to just a plain little logo, this is a really nice way to go. And of course, again, you could move this around in terms of your shape or whatever you want to do. Now, let's say we just want to add a little bit of copy in here, then we can. Of course, you wouldn't want to in this case usually because this font is so specific. So unless you have the font, you're not going to want to do that. So, but I'm going to click on my type tool. And I'm going to go ahead and change it to black. And I'm going to just type in something really simple. I don't know, hi or something, right? Just to show you how it works. So I'm going to move this down. I just held down control there, by the way, to give me this tool, the select tool. And then you can see that it's not casting a shadow. And of course, the reason it's not casting a shadow is not because it's behind the light necessarily, but because it's not 3D. And once it's 3D, we can change its position and move it towards us, as long as we change its material properties. So here, cast shadows needs to be on. As soon as we cast those shadows, it's done. So again, this becomes a very, very useful way to mess with things. And you can see that the shadows are moving as it moves in connection to the light. So you can see the light is pointing from the left to the right. So that's where what happens to the shadow. And the closer we come to the light, the closer it is here. So you can see if this was to fly in from the side, it would actually have a really, really cool effect to it. So that's all you need to know to be able to start playing with logos. Enjoy.